first supplementary question by DR Ryder.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. And thank you, Mr. President, for your answer. But sir, similar to your appointment of Mr. Mabuza, when you were the Deputy President and the Leader of Government Business, President Zuma appointed you, specifically in December 2014, with, and I quote, overseeing the turnaround at Eskom. That was 2014. I believe that you failed the country and that you should shoulder the blame for the situation that we find ourselves in. Mr. Gordhan, Minister Gordhan, is on record saying that Eskom was a state capture project. You were complicit. Why did you not intervene to save Eskom and the country's economy when you had the chance and you were given the full responsibility to do so?
Is that the question? Okay. So I was the leader of the state capture project. Very nice. Well, I guess one should be quite direct in answering the question because the honorable member is hallucinating a little bit. And in direct answer, I think what we have been observing with what's been happening in Eskom is that we've been dealing with a really deep-rooted problem of corruption and state capture. My own sense is that if there ever was an entity of government that was totally and completely captured, it was Eskom. And it was easy to capture because they were able to see how big it is. The biggest corporation in our country generates a revenue that is far above many other companies in our country. And once they set their eyes on Eskom as a target, they went in with a great deal of effectiveness. And quite a lot of what was happening there was hidden, and it is really only coming to light now through the various commissions that are now underway. Even as we had the war room, we could see there were challenges, and the challenges seem to be more technical as well as financial, but it had to take a lot of digging to finally find that in the end some of the suppliers were overpaid, quite a lot of money was being siphoned out without even invoicing and all that. So let us pay tribute where tribute is due. Let us pay tribute to the work that the various commissions are doing to fathom exactly what has happened in Eskom. And in the end, when Eskom will be completely repositioned, because much of what we have been doing over this time is to seek to reposition Eskom. It's very easy to point fingers and to find people who are to blame. My own approach is let us all work together to try and reposition Eskom, because Eskom is too big to fail. It is far too important to fail, and it is far too important to do finger pointing. What we now need to do is to reposition Eskom and look at the restructuring that is ongoing. What I outlined here is something that we should all applaud and say we can now see the light of day. We can see that something is being done. We are going to appoint a CEO. We are going to add and augment to the board. We are going to deal with the debt. We're dealing now with the operational aspects, the technical aspects. We're working hard to complete the two power stations. And we're also having to deal with the challenge of non-payment. And a combination of all these give rise to a challenge that all of us should face up to and address with a view of finding solutions. And if ever there was a time, this is not a time for finger pointing. This is a time of trying to bring good ideas together to solve the problem. Thank you very much, Chairperson.